You know, every single day, we're all faced with choices. Should I buy this coffee or should I save the money? Should I stay up and study for one more hour or just get some sleep? Well, these aren't just little personal problems. They're actually at the very heart of economics, and it all boils down to one single fundamental issue.
It's the ultimate question, isn't it? We have endless wants, you know, big dreams and all these desires, but we live in a world that has limits. Limited time, limited money, limited resources. So why? Why can't we just have everything we want?
Well, the answer has a name, scarcity. It's this simple but really powerful idea that what we want will always, always outstrip what we have. Now, this isn't some kind of flaw in the system. It's just the basic condition of our world. And if you can understand this one concept, you're on your way to understanding every economic choice we make.
Okay, so to really get a handle on this whole idea of scarcity and choice, let's do something kind of fun. We're going to build a tiny, super simplified economy right here from scratch. I think by seeing how it works visually, the idea of a trade-off is going to become crystal clear.
So in our little miniature economy, we've only got one resource, labor. We have a population of exactly 100 workers. That's it. They are the entire engine for everything we produce. Nice and simple, right?
So what can these workers actually do? Well, each worker has a choice. They can spend their day producing either 2 tons of wheat or 5 tons of milk. The key word there is or. They can't do both at the same time. And this, right here, is our fundamental trade-off.
All right, with these simple rules in place, we can now map out every single possible production combination our little economy can make. Let's actually draw a map of our economic world.
So let's start at one extreme. What if our society just decided, you know what? We only want wheat. We put every single worker, all our effort, into making just that one thing. What would that look like?
Well, the math is pretty easy. We've got 100 workers, and each one of them can produce 2 tons of wheat. So if everyone is making wheat, we get a maximum of 200 tons. That's one edge of our economic world right there.
Okay, so now let's flip it. What if we go all in on milk instead? We dedicate all 100 workers to nothing but dairy production. What's the absolute limit there?
Again, super straightforward. 100 workers, and they each produce 5 tons of milk. That gives us a grand total of 500 tons. And this is so important because we've now found the two extremes of our economic world, either 200 tons of wheat and zero milk, or 500 tons of milk and zero wheat.
Now these 2 points, they don't just sit there. They actually define the boundaries of our entire economy. The line that connects them shows every possible combination of wheat and milk we can produce if we're using all of our workers efficiently. In economics, this line has a pretty cool name. It's called the Production Possibility Frontier, or PPF for short.
I mean, let's be real. An economy usually wants a little bit of everything, right? So let's pick a point somewhere on that line. What if our society decides we need exactly 40 tons of milk? How much wheat can we still make alongside it?
Okay, let's break it down. To get those 40 tons of milk, and we know each worker makes 5 tons, well, we're going to need 8 workers for that job. That leaves 92 workers free. So what can they do? They can make wheat. 92 workers times 2 tons each. That gives us 184 tons of wheat.
And there we have it. A new point right on our frontier line. 184 tons of wheat and 40 tons of milk. This combination is totally possible, and it's efficient because every single one of our 100 workers has a job. We're using our resources to the absolute fullest.
So now we know what's possible and efficient, any point that's on that line. But what about the areas inside the line or outside of it? They tell a really crucial story about how well our economy is actually running.
Let's test out a different scenario. Someone comes up with a new goal. Let's produce 60 tons of wheat and 160 tons of milk. Can we do it? Is this point even on our frontier?
Let's run the numbers. To get 60 tons of wheat, you'd need 30 workers. For 160 tons of milk, you'd need 32 workers. So you add those up, and you only need 62 of our 100 workers. So what's happening with the other 38?
This means the point is inside our frontier. We can absolutely produce this amount, no problem, but it's inefficient. We have 38 workers just sitting around doing nothing. In the real world, this represents things like unemployment or wasted resources. We could be producing more of everything.
And what about a point outside the curve? Let's say 200 tons of wheat and 100 tons of milk. Well, with our current resources and our current technology, that's just a dream. It's impossible. For now, anyway.
So, does that mean we're just stuck with these limits forever? No way! Economies can grow, they can become way more productive, and they can absolutely push past their old frontiers. Let's see exactly how that happens.
Let's imagine a huge breakthrough. Someone invents a new milking machine, and all of a sudden, a single worker can produce 8 tons of milk a day instead of just 5. This is a classic technological improvement, a huge boost in productivity.
And just look at what this does to our potential. If we put all 100 workers on milk production now, we don't get 500 tons anymore. We get a massive 800 tons. Now notice, our maximum wheat production, that hasn't changed, but our potential for milk has just exploded.
This, right here, is what economic growth actually looks like. The entire production possibility frontier pushes outward. Those combinations that were once impossible dreams, they're now totally within our reach. We can have more milk without even giving up any wheat. This is how societies get richer and how standards of living improve.
And this really brings us to the big picture. This simple little model of wheat and milk, it applies to absolutely everything, from building software with AI to developing new energy sources. It shows us that while we always face limits, human ingenuity and technology are constantly working to push those limits further and further out. And it leaves us with one final, pretty exciting question. What frontier are we going to break through next?